After fears of widespread refusal to comply with the current 14-day self-isolation guidelines, the government is drawing up new rules that could see it slashed to as little as 7 days and even make some travellers totally exempt from all quarantine.
But will halving isolation times increase public compliance and limit the spread, or could it have the opposite effect? To discuss this, we're joined now by Professor Devi Sridhar, Chair of Global Public Health at Edinburgh University, and billionaire businessman and philanthropist John Caudwell. And Dr. Hillary, of course, is with us as well.
John Caudwell, coming to you, I mean, do you think Devi Sridhar was there saying, obviously, a self-isolation period of 14 days is tough for people financially, emotionally? It's difficult for members of staff who have to take that time off work. It's difficult for businesses, isn't it, who then potentially have members of staff off for extended periods of time because of this. Would you welcome a change like this?
Yeah, yes, of course, I welcome a change like this, but I think it's really scratching around at the edges of what's going to make a difference. These are tiny, tiny tweaks, but some of them are sensible because they're talking now about allowing chief executives to travel without quarantine. And I'll give you an example of the stupidity of the rules at the moment. I'm not criticising the government for this because the rules are so complex and so many different variations. But I held my children's charity for Caudwell Children in Monaco a month ago. And I went across, we raised £1.3 million. Then I had to quarantine for 2 weeks. Meanwhile, cross-border workers, they might be plumbers, builders, bricklayers, whatever, could travel backwards and forwards quite freely. So the rules are very, very mixed and very illogical. But of course, it is a huge challenge for the government to get all of this right, including these lockdown all these lockdown rules. And that's why we have such a huge amount of confusion in the public and so many people disagreeing with so many different measures.
Yeah, so there was this suggestion that people like city deal makers, hedge fund managers, company bosses could be exempt. We did hear from Brandon Lewis yesterday, who said any changes that are made will apply to everybody. From your point of view, as a company boss, would you be worried if staff were coming back after 7 days? You know, we've had all this advice for however long, saying that we need to self-isolate if we've been in contact with someone who's tested positive for 14 days. So would that be a worry that staff might be coming back too soon?
No, because this is where the nonsense is. People are travelling back often from countries where the incidence of corona is way lower than ours. The new cases per day are way lower. The percentage of the population is lower. And yet, when you travel back from those countries into our country where the cases are 20,000 a day, you've got to then isolate for 14 days as if you've caught the plague out in those countries. And I think it's just a matter of being sensible, taking the appropriate precautions, use your sanitizer, the face masks, and avoid close physical contact. And I think if you do all this, then whether you're traveling back from Italy or Spain, the risk is probably no higher than going to a British supermarket. So why impose these massive restrictions?